Hello, everyone, and welcome to part three of our little mini-series showcasing the difference in impact that both Erling Haaland and Darwin Nunez will have at their clubs via the Football Manager simulation. Right, so we are here. If you've not seen the previous two episodes, I'd suggest you go out and check those out first. The links will be in the description down below. But we are here at the end of season number 11. As you can see, Man City have won the league once again, 9 points clear of Arsenal. Liverpool dropping into the Europa League. It just gets worse and worse for Liverpool, doesn't it, really? Man City once again dominating. What's this now? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, something like 10 seasons in a row, is that now? God knows. It's a lot, though, isn't it? Right, so let's have a quick look at these guys then. So, Jadon Harrison, top goal scorer in the Premiership, good young English player. And Ben Linden for the second season in a row. He's been fantastic signing for Leicester from Sheffield United, wasn't he? But yeah, Erling Haaland, 21 goals at the age of 31, still going strong. I think he would have played less games this season. But first of all, let's check on Darwin Nunez. Is he still there? He is still there. 39 games, 11 goals, 5 assists. I think he's just being outdone now. I mean, they've got Vlahovic now signed up by the looks of it. They've still got Sesko, who's wanted by Juventus. And they've got Iñaki Cuevas, the young Andorran, who's been doing incredibly well for them as well. But yeah, Darwin Nunez, 40 games overall combined, 11 goals, 5 assists. Is that enough? I don't think it is. I mean, when you've got players like Sesko, who starts 9 games and gets 21 sub-appearances and he comes up with 13, or Iñaki Cuevas, this is probably the best person to look at because Nunez is playing more up the left wing now with Vlahovic or Sesko as the main striker. And then you've got Cuevas playing up the right wing. So he's playing the other side to Nunez. And look at the contribution he's giving compared. 13 goals, 15 assists compared to 11 goals, 5 assists. So, again, he's doing well, Nunez, but he's just still not up to scratch with the rest of the team, I don't think. Or the where they need him to be honest. Where they need him to be, right. And that's why they've probably dropped into the Europa League. Let's head over and have a look at Manchester City then once again. Erling Haaland, 33 goals in 54 games. 10 assists as well, so 43 goals contributed to the team. The old Danish player gets stronger and stronger, doesn't he, really? He's looked fantastic. Phil Foden, once again, has contributed 19 goals and 5 assists. We've got the young Dutch midfielder who's also contributing quite a lot as well. It's been another very interesting season. Haaland, once again, just strong as anything, isn't he, really? And is that... No, they lost the Champions League final to Real Madrid this year. Let's have a quick look at the actual Champions League itself. Right, so we've got... So Man City did win it 5 years in a row. Then Munich got it, Liverpool got it, City got it back, and then Real Madrid picked up this victory. Highest goal scorer was this guy, Brazilian striker and right midfielder. So I do just like having a look through these regens every now and again. They're quite fun to look for, aren't they? But yeah, end of season 11, Haaland's still going strong. Darwin Nunez starting to, I don't know, I mean, he is now, is he 32 now or is he 31? Let's have a quick look. I mean, he is 32. He's just about to become 33. So, to be honest, there's only probably another one or two seasons in him. So, well, let's head to the end of season number 12 and see if he can have a bit of a swan song here in the Premiership. Right, then the end of season 12, Manchester City once again winning the Premiership by 10 clear points. And once again, Liverpool finishing outside the Champions League spots. But the big difference is, as you can see, that Erling Haaland has not made it on to the top goal scorer. The top three goal scorers in the Premiership. Ben Linden, once again, top. He's been fantastic the last two seasons. Or three seasons, should I say. Harrison from Chelsea as well. And Vlahovic from Liverpool, who obviously has become their main striker now. Knocking in with 20 goals. So let's check on Nunez first. See if he's still there. He is still there, okay. 38 games, 7 goals, 8 assists. So contributed 15 goals this season. Again, not great. He's wanted by Real Madrid at the age of 33. He's about to become 34. But as you can see, I think he's been... I mean, he's contributing a lot of games, but I mean, this is where the stats are coming from. Vlahovic with 30 goals. Cuevas with 13 goals, 12 assists. Thiago Almeida is now over here as well. He's doing pretty well. A new one, Demir Lojo from Bosnia. He's doing pretty well. Of course, they've got John Proud, the Scotsman. 77 caps at the age of 26. That's incredible, isn't it, really? But yeah, I think his career is starting to wind up now. He has definitely been a success for Liverpool, don't get me wrong. He'll have a lot of fans out there, a lot of loyal Liverpool fans. He's been there for now for, was it 11 or 12 seasons? Scored a decent amount of goals, taken them to Champions League finals and Champions League winning sides and all that sort of stuff. So I think he'll be very happy. Where's the... Is there like a... I'm sure there is somewhere. There's like a trophy cabinet thing, isn't it, where you can see all their medals? Milestones? FA Cup winners. Let's see, competitions. There we go. So won the FA Cup. Copa America runners-up. Carabao Cup winners. FA Cup winners. Champions League winners. Community Shield, Community Shield. UEFA Super Cup. Club World Championship runners-up, Europa League winners. So he's won a hell of a lot of stuff. Oh, that's ignore that. That's with the old club, isn't it? So he has won a lot of stuff with Liverpool. And like I said, I think he'll still be classed a bit of a hero by the club. But let's move on then to Haaland. Let's see what he's been up to. Is he still there? He is still there. Still got 24 goals, 13 assists for Manchester City at the age of 32. And he will be 33 before the next season begins. So 12 goals in the Premiership, 3 in the FA Cup, 2 in the Carabao Cup, and 7 in the Champions League. 13 assists overall as well. I mean, he's still doing pretty well, but again, it's probably the same with him. His career is now starting to come towards a close, isn't it, really? Champions League forward of the season, which he's had a hell of a lot again. Right, Champions League, is that finished yet? Real Madrid got it in the second year in a row, beating PSG this time in the final. That's sort of reigned Man City's rundown. They lost to PSG 5-4 on aggregate in the semis. That's not ideal for them, is it, really? Haaland, I think he's starting to bring the season down. I mean, he is still the second highest goal scorer this year in the Premiership. I mean, both their careers are starting to come to a close now, both him and Nunez, and they're starting to get replaced by the next batch of Wonder Kids, aren't they, really? So it'll be interesting to see just how far the pair of them can go. So let's head to the end of season number 13, and we'll see if we're still going strong. So once again, the end of the season, Manchester City win the league, but only by 2 points this time, one of the closest results they've had in quite some time. And Liverpool again finishing fifth, just outside the Champions League, painfully for them, only by goal difference, 2 goals behind Newcastle United, so they'll be disappointed with that one. George Nino looks like a player that's contributed to that. The Colombian striker looks fantastic stat-wise, doesn't he, really? And then Lindon and Harrison once again both looking absolutely great. Let's check on Nunez first. Is he still there? No, he is gone. Okay. Let's see where he went to then. Darwin Nunez went to Lyon for $13.75 million. He's been there for one season. Got himself 17 goals in the Uber Eats League, 6 assists. So probably one of his better seasons, to be honest. He's done really well there. And it's probably a nice little place for him to wind down his career. He'll get another good 2 or 3 seasons. Well, probably not 3, like, but I mean another season or so out of this little... job over to Leon. And like I said, I think it's been great for Liverpool. I think he's been a fantastic player. He's been there for many years, doing a lot of great things, winning a lot of trophies with them. But I say it's just been a bad time for them because Manchester City have just become so dominant, especially with Haaland. It's been very, very tricky. But Nunez, of course, over in Leon now. His Liverpool career has come to an end, and they still managed to get nearly 14 million for him back. So, I mean, if you consider you paid 81 million here, you had him for, say, 12, 13 seasons and got another 14 million back. I think you've definitely got his value, haven't you, really? Definitely got his value over the entirety of his career. So I don't think it's a flop. I think it could have been better, don't get me wrong, with these stats, but I don't think it's a flop. And I think he's going to be a very good signing for Liverpool. But let's head back over then to Manchester City then. Is Erling Haaland still around? He is, and he's got another 29 goals in 46 games, 19 in the Premier League. But that was not enough to get him on the top chunk, was it? No. That's only because there's a lot of really high goal scorers this season. But 19 in the Premier League, 8 in the Champions League, 2 in the FA Cup. So again, a pretty damn strong season for him. 274 goals in 429 games. But again, he's going to come towards the end of his career soon. He's 34, he's going to be, when the next season begins. So I don't know how much longer he is going to go for. Let me just check Darwin Nunez while we're here. So he finished his Liverpool career with 110 goals in 357 appearances. So, yeah, I mean, it's been a good time for him. Definitely a good time. But Haaland has just been an absolute beast. And I wouldn't expect this from anybody, to be honest. That sort of goal-scoring record is club legend style of scoring records, isn't it, really? 274 goals in 429 games is absolutely insane. Right, then, let us move on to the end of season number 14 and see how long Haaland lasts at Man City. Here we go, the end of season 14. Liverpool back up into the Champions League spots. Sheffield United got Europa Conference League. Man United have dropped down to 8th position. So I'm a Man United fan. I just want to check what the hell's going on. It's not looking great, is it, really? Their best player is this guy. French defender. Not looking great at all, is it, really? Anyway, let's not get sidetracked by that. That's not what this is about. This is about now. I mean, since Darwin Nunez has left Liverpool, we are now checking solely on Manchester City. Haaland, third highest goal scorer for the team. 20 goals in 36 games with 5 assists. Still looking pretty strong. He is available for the under-18s for some reason. I would only imagine his career is coming close to an end now. So, yeah, it's been a decent season for him once again. Premier League champions, Carabao Cup winners. Let's have a quick look and see what has happened. I should imagine he's no longer fighting for the Ballon d'Or. He might be a little bit old for that now. There might be better players knocking around. Yeah, I mean, last 4 years, Foden nicked it. That was an all-Man City top three. Wow. Then Camavinga, as Real Madrid really starting to pick it back up now. And then Jude Bellingham ahead of Sergio Immaz from Juventus. And then Leo, who's looking like a real fantastic player, this one, isn't he, really, for Manchester City. He's been a real good find for them. But yeah, I think Erling Haaland's career is starting to come to a close now. He's going to be 35 before the next season begins. It'll be interesting to see if he can get another season going. But at this point in time, I can't see why not. He's got the ability. He's got the stats. So let's head to the end of season 15 and see if Haaland pushed it for one more year. And here we go, the end of season number 15. Interesting season, this one. Look how Chelsea and Man United, 11th and 12th, is pretty bad, isn't it, really? You got Leicester, Everton, Newcastle getting Champions League again. Liverpool in third. Spurs got second. But once again, for like the 12th, 13th year in a row, Manchester City have won the league. Ben Linden again, absolutely incredible striker for Leicester, knocking in goals for fun. Joel Reid's a new one. Northern Irish striker, 88 caps, 56 goals for the 28-year-old. And then Jorge Nino again on that goal-scoring record. But let's see if Erling Haaland has continued. Oh, he has. He's vice-captain, so he's still there. He's still there, but he is going to be leaving this summer. So I think we'll call this the last season then. So he managed to get himself 9 goals from 14 starts and 17 substitute appearances. So there's not as many goals going in now that Haaland's career is coming towards an end, but he's still just an incredible player, isn't he, really? Let's face it. Absolutely incredible player. He's going to finish his Manchester City career with 294 goals in 476 appearances, which is absolutely insanely good, isn't it, really? Absolutely insanely good. Premiership records. Did he break any of those? Any more of those? That is, he didn't get more than 60 goals in a season, obviously, did he? He got the highest average rating. Alfredo Morelos. Yeah, that's not no surprise there, really, is it? No, I don't like anything else has been broken. Most goals in a season, he got that considerably a few times. But yeah, it's been a fantastic career for both of them, really. Like I said, take nothing away from Darwin Nunez. I don't think he's going to be a bad signing. I just think he's going to really struggle to keep up with the incredible stats that the likes of Erling Haaland has been able to push through. So we'll leave it there. Hopefully you've enjoyed. Hopefully this has been a bit of fun for you. Like I said, this is just a game. This is not necessarily what is going to happen. In my opinion, what's going to happen, I think Nunez will fit into Liverpool like a glove. I think he plays their same style of play. He will be able to fit into that quite nicely. As long as he can get to grips with the physical and the pace of the Premiership compared to where he came from, just like Lucas Diaz was able to at Liverpool, I think he's going to be a very good fit and a very good signing. Erling Haaland, I mean, I'm clutching at straws here because we know he's going to be incredible, but I'm clutching at straws as a Man United fan. He has had some injury issues over the last year or so. Has he been too overplayed at a young age? That's a question. And as a lot of people have said, his style and Manchester City's style don't really mesh at this point in time. So one of them is going to have to adapt, I think, for the other. And I think that might take a little bit of time, but I think if they can get that perfected, then he is going to be an absolute lethal individual. How many caps has he got now? That's an interesting one. 106 caps, 117 goals for his country. He's an absolute nutter. But there we go. I'm going to love you and leave you. Thank you very much for watching this little mini-series. Hope you've enjoyed. If you have, hit that like button, subscribe, and let me know in the comment section down below. And I'll see you all next time. Bye-bye.